The blessing business, without God on my side, I cannot do anything. So we have a caller on the line. Go right ahead, caller.
All right, caller.
Go ahead, caller.
Yes, can you hear me okay?
Yes, sir, yes. Go right ahead.
Okay, Lee Adams.
Yes, sir.
Via Saeed.
Yes.
And I don't remember if it's George or Jural.
It's Jural.
Just Jural?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Yeah, I'm of the firm belief that people haven't changed probably in 100 plus years. Mm. So I don't think that people are much different than when Lee Adams was conceived, raised, and raised into the in this world. I don't accept that as truth. What I do accept as truth is it's much, much easier to expose the flaws than it was maybe as many as 35 years ago in family upbringing than it was before. And information travels much faster now.
Amen.
So I'm inclined to believe very strongly that there were a lot of things that were going on, say, in the 1930s or 40s, that people just weren't aware of as much because information didn't pass on as fast. And a perfect example of what I'm referencing is that you'll hear people say often, kids, what's the problem with kids today? Well, the problem with kids today are the parents of today and the grandparents and great-grandparents of yesterday. People don't just evolve or dissolve into certain types of behavior. You follow me?
I follow you. That's the truth, though.
And it's the same thing with pluses.
To some degree.
It's the same thing with the pluses of human behavior as well. The benevolence that exists in the human race has been the same since the human race has existed, began. So people aren't that different. And I don't think children are any more respectful. There's more children than there have ever been, you know, in the history of the human race right now. So there's more to look at. But if you really pay attention, the people that raise their children well now are doing the same as people that raised their children well 100 years ago. And they're turning out the same. It's just more people now.
But there's more people in the world today than it was yesterday.
Yes.
But let me tell you one thing. Without raising your child right from the beginning, that's why so many children is going to jail for what? For what they did wrong. And there's more children today and adults is behind bars, and that's the truth.
That is.
And we can't forget to put God in it. You know, God in
We have to put God
in our family.
If we don't put God in our families, then we are going wrong.
Well, I will say this, because we're all black. I assume Gerald's black.
Yeah.
He's an alien.
I tend to focus on black issues.
Because illegal alien. I might get sent back to England.
Oh, Uranus.
I'm inclined to say that there's one thing that we should point to as a problem in our community, our segment of the population. On the majority, on the whole, we do a bad job of starting our families. You'll hear people talk about.
How can you say that? How can you say we do a bad job?
On the whole. And I'm not saying.
Do you have a family?
So are you black?
Do you have a family?
We didn't ask you that.
Most black children in this country.
I asked you, do you have a family?
You asked me, do I have a family? I do.
You have children?
I do.
You have children?
I do. Can you hear me?
Yes.
I do.
What are your ages, your children?
Well, I'm not willing to say that. I'm not giving too much of my personal information, but
I'm just asking what their ages are.
There are four of them, and they range from early preteen to late teen. Okay.
Are you a good father?
I am.
Are you sure about that?
I am.
Now they saying it.
I am.
Okay.
A father and a mother are, whether a father's good or bad, is determined by the quality of the child that they raise.
Amen on that, brother.
All right.
What I was getting ready to say was, on the whole, we have, and I'm what I'm about to tell you, I'm guilty of on this first one. I'm guilty of doing this, and I'm also a product of what I'm about to tell you as well. Mm-hmm. Children that were not planned prior to conception, between two people who have a plan to begin and raise children, that is a common problem.
Yeah.
And if you don't have a worked out agreement before conception, meaning something like, okay, you may be married and you didn't plan your children, but there's an agreement that works by virtue of you being married and building a healthy friendship. If you conceive some children in that marriage at a time that you didn't really intend to, you still have a plan surrounding the plan.
Are you married?
No.
You're not married?
No.
Do you ever think about getting married?
I thought about it. I'm not interested. I don't want a license attached to that part of my life.
So how many mothers do you have?
That I'm not saying.
So you got
100.
Well, let me finish this. I answered any question you
want to
say.
I've answered any questions so far I've asked you. You've not answered a single question that I've asked you.
I will if you let me finish this.
And by the way, I want to interview you. A lot of people want to see what you look like. So if you
after. Lee Adams, I have a question for you. Since we're on a time restricted broadcast, may I be allowed to finish what I was going to say?
Go ahead, yes, sir.
Okay, cool. All right, what I was getting ready to say was, however, if you're not married and you still build a healthy friendship between the mother and the father, and then you sit down and talk about what you may want as an individual, as a parent, and then you make some decisions on where you may be in agreement and where you may not be in agreement and make a compromise, then you usually have a good shot raising a good child and consequently contributing heavily to a productive pursuit of your ancestry. However, we haven't done that on the whole in our community. So when you hear people talk about, and I'm referencing the black population, and when you hear people talk about the problem with children in our particular community, those are the reasons why. And I repeat, I'm a product of that. I wasn't planned. And I'm a product of that with my first child. She wasn't planned.
That's the problem. The problem is there was a time when the African-American community was a little bit more God conscious. And so they had a little bit more moral standards than they do now. A lot more moral standards than they do now. And because we've been mixing and, you know, got all these ideologies mixed into our pretty much bloodline, there's some atheists that got along our bloodline, didn't believe in God. So there's some of us who are venturing off into that. And so then when it comes to no sex before marriage, there's a lot of them not doing it because in this country, particularly, this country makes sexual freedom such a normal thing when actually, you know, it leads to a whole lot of things from unwanted pregnancies, unwanted fatherhood, diseases, eventually abortions because people don't want their children, and hurt emotions, tore up families, you name it, even rape and all kinds of other stuff, you know. So there has to be some kind of structured discipline and cultural cohesiveness, you know, to bring us back together because we've lost it because we're trying to become someone else that whom we're not really. As a race of people, we've been trying to, because we've been so, a lot of us been so poor and disadvantaged so long, we see there's opportunity we don't have, so we figure that we'd become like the conquerors, then maybe we'll have something, you know. And maybe have hair blonde and everything else the same, you know. So, but there's and I'm gonna go when Deacon Leanna say his part. There's something about something that a lot of us is not aware of that's actually causing disruption in the black community, that's affecting how the children are being raised. Go ahead, Deacon Leanna.
But I feel that we should all come to understanding about how.